In an FSH cycle, what we're trying to do is induce ovulation in women who do not normally ovulate, who are anovulatory. If they use the FSH medication alone, they may ovulate 4, 5, 6, 7 eggs, and in fact, part of the monitoring in an FSH cycle is to cancel cycles which are overinduced. Now, if you're ovulating 4 or 5 eggs, you have the risk of 4 or 5 babies being formed in the cycle. And in the United States, the primary cause of triplet, quads, and quint pregnancies is not IVF, it's actually the use of FSH cycles alone. Therefore, if we can substitute a technique that allows us to decrease the number of embryos that are actually in the body while increasing the likelihood of pregnancy, we not only improve outcome, but we decrease cost in the long run, because the cost of a triplet, quad, or quint pregnancy is related to the aftercare. IVF offers us that opportunity. IVF can be run in Jane multiple follicle induction, we can do the egg retrieval, we can generate embryos in the laboratory, and then we can sort through the embryos and pick out 2 embryos for transfer, or 1 embryo for transfer, and limit our pregnancy to a singleton or twin gestation, and freeze the rest of the embryos for comparatively inexpensive second and third chances, thereby decreasing the overall risk to the patient and decreasing the possibility of a multiple gestation. Unfortunately, even while the insurance companies say this approach makes sense, they won't cover it. And therefore, the patients are left with the decision of, do I do the FSH cycle, which may be covered, and run the risk, or do I switch to the IVF procedure, which carries less long-term risk for me, but I'm going to have to pay for myself. I would just encourage the patients to not be penny wise and pound foolish. In the long run, a triplet, quad, or quint pregnancy is going to be a pregnancy that is going to be terribly expensive, not only for the insurance company, but for the patient as well.